Dear students, now I will solve the problem on Runge-Kutta fourth order method, the second order ordinary differential equations with the initial conditions to approximate the next value of x, we call it. This is the problem given. Solve y double dash equal to x into y dash minus y with initial conditions y0 equal to 3, y dash 0 is equal to 0 to approximate y at point 1 using RK fourth order method. Here, this problem will be reduced. This is the given differential equation is of the second order, but we have written the formulas for the first order to ordinary differential equations. Then we will reduce this second order differential equation into two first order ordinary differential equations. Then the formulations which are defined in terms of k and in terms of l, we are going to use in order to approximate the value of y at x equal to 0.1. Then, first of all, let me take the given data. Given that y double dash equal to x into y dash minus y. Or it is d square y divided by dx square equal to x into dy by dx and minus of y. The initial conditions are given like this. We call them as ICs. That is first initial condition. Y at x naught equal to 0, this is equal to 0, and y dash at x naught is equal to 0, this is equal to 0. This is 3 and this is equal to 0. What is to be calculated? Y at x equal to x naught plus h, this is x naught is 0, and plus of 0.1 we take to approximate this. This is equal to x1 equal to how much? By Runge-Kutta method. Then you can easily prepare the table. This table takes the meaning like this, that is x and y, that is x naught is 0, first value it is given, initial condition, and 0.1. It is 0 and here it is what value? By RK method. This is what the table you can construct and then see that how these formulations can be applied. Now, I will reduce this second order differential equation into first order differential equation. While reducing this second order differential equation into first order differential equation, we will come across two first order ordinary differential equations. Like the first order derivative, that is dy by dx equal to z we define, and this implies dz by dx, this is equal to d square y divided by it is dx square. Then if I call this equation as 1, then 1 becomes left side, that is dz by dx, dz by dx equal to x into z and minus of y is there. Now another equation, that is dy by dx equal to z. Here we define two functional values. Left side is a derivative, whereas right side is not a derivative. Right side is including the variables, but left side is a derivative. How the first order differential equation in Runge-Kutta method, Euler's method, Taylor series method we have solved, and we considered their first order differential equation with the initial condition as y at x naught is equal to y naught, like that. Here also we come across these two equations in the same fashion. Then this I will take it as the first function f1 of x comma y comma z, and this I will take it as f2 comma x comma y comma z. Here the solution we have to obtain
while obtaining the solution y for this differential equation, we do expect the solution for another differential equation, that is dz by dx. Here we consider that is z equal to z at x. What is that? Z at x is equal to z at x equal to x1, because x1 is 0 plus 0.1, that is 0.1. So this is equal to z naught initial value plus L, and here this is the solution we come across y at x equal to x1, that is equal to y naught, the initial value of y, and plus L. What plus k? What is L and what is k? They are contributed from Runge-Kutta fourth order formulations. Those equations we have to write, and we have to see that the given set of differential equation and initial conditions are to be used, and then we have to obtain the value of L. What is L here? L equal to 1 by 6, that is L1, plus 2 times L2, 2 times L3, plus L4. This is the value of L. And k value, k is equal to, that is 1 by 6 multiplied by k1 plus 2 times k2 plus 2 times k3 and plus k4. These are the formulations we studied in the previous discussion. So that after getting the value of L, here we add, and then we will be getting z at x equal to x1. What is the answer? Similarly, here after getting the value of k, then we will be able to get the value of, after getting the value of k using this formula, then we will be getting what is the value of y at x equal to x1. Then we consider these four formulations for solving the differential equation in the individual calculation. Individual calculation means what is k1, what is k2, what is k3, what is k4. So also values of L1, L2, L3, L4. Let me calculate for this given data in that fashion. Let me take those two equations, set up two sets of equations. They are defined like this, where k1 equal to h into f1 of x0, y0 and z0, and k2 equal to h into f of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k1 by 2 and z0 plus l1 by 2. Now what is L1? That is L1 equal to h into f of, that is f2, second function for this we have taken, and for this first function we have taken, that is x0, y0 and z0. Then L2, that is equal to h into f of, that is x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k1 by 2 and z0 plus l1 by 2. Next k3, k3 equal to h into, that is f of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k1 by 2 z0 plus l1 by 2. Here l2, here k2. So here k1 and l1, previously calculated value we have to substitute. Then here l3, l3 is equal to h into, this is f2 and this is f1, then f2 of x0 plus h by 2, y0 plus k2 divided by 2 and z0 plus L2 divided by 2. Then what is this to be calculated? The last value of k and l will be like this. That is k4 is equal to h into f1 of x0 plus h and y0 plus it is k3 and z0 plus l3. These are the formulations given by Runge-Kutta fourth order method. Then l4 is equal to h into f2 of x0 plus h comma y0 plus k3 and z0 plus l3. So these are the values, that means set of calculation. These are the formulations which will be defined for k and l series. Okay. Now what are the values of k1 and l1? Initially we calculate. Means this is equal to h into, here the calculation is table, that is x, y and z. What is x naught? X naught equal to 0, y naught equal to 0, and another one is, that is y naught equal to 3, another one is, that is z naught, that is y naught dash. Y naught dash means z naught, that is equal to 0. Now x1 equal to x naught plus h equal to 0.1. So what is this value and what is this z value? Then here h into, that means h value should be 0.1, here I will write, and f of x0 is 0, y0 is 3 and it is 0. Then what we will calculate here, we will have to substitute these values in, that is function, that is f1. So f1 is nothing but z, therefore 0.1 here, 0.1, this is the coefficient, and in place of x you put it as 0, in place of y you put it as 3, in place of z you put it as 0. But x is not there, y is not there in the function, that is f1. That is f1 is nothing but dy by dx, that is equal to z, and dz by dx equal to f2, that is x into z and then minus y is there, x into z minus y is there. So we have to use these two functions in these two sets of formulations, that is 0.1 multiplied to, that is z value 0, that is equal to 0, therefore k1 is 0. Now you have to write l1, that is equal to same value, that is 0.1, and f of x0 is 0, y0 is 3 and z0 is 0. You substitute those values, x as x0 and z as z0 and y as y0. So here you have to substitute, that is x0, z0 and minus of y0. What is this? This is equal to x0 is 0 into z0 is 0 minus this one. This is anyway multiplied by h, that is 0.1, 0.1, and then minus of y0, minus 3 into 0.1. This is equal to minus 0.3. This is the value of L1. So now K2 you have to work out. So to calculate K2, then this is equal to h value, it is 0.1, and f1 of x0 0 plus 0.1 divided by 2, y0 is 3 plus, that is k1 is 0 by 2, and z0 is 0 minus 0.3, this one minus 0.3 and divided by 2. Here k2 value comes minus of this one 0.015. This is with minus sign. This is k2. Now similarly, L2, that is 0.1 into F2 of same values you have to write. 0 plus 0.1 divided by 2, 3 plus 0 by 2, comma 0 minus 0.3 divided by 2. So L2 value takes, this is equal to minus of 0.3 double 0, it is 75. This is for L2. Then K3, this is nothing but 0.1 and F1 of x naught, that is 0 plus 0.1 by 2 and y naught, it is 3 plus k2. What is k2? k2 is this much, minus 0.015 divided by 2, and z naught is 0, and L2. L2 is minus 0.30075. Only z is there. In the case of F1, only this value has to be multiplied by 0.1. So that comes to be 3 value minus of 0.01035. This is K3. Similarly, you must calculate L3, 0.1, and F2 of x0 is 0, plus of 0.1 divided by 2, y0 is 3, and K2. K2 is minus 0.015 divided by 2, z0 is 0, and L2, that is this much, minus of 0.30075 divided by 2. This L3 takes the value minus 0.34018. This is L3. Then K4. This is equal to 0.1 multiplied by F1 of, that is 0 plus 0.1. This is nothing but x1, and y0 plus k3, that is 3 minus 0.01035, and z0 is 0 plus of L3. L3 is this much, minus 0.34018. This comes to be K4 value, comes to be minus 0.34018, that much. K3 is this much, and K4 is this value, that is K4 is 0.03401, not 18. Then L4, you must use the same values. Then L4 takes the value minus of 0.3014962. So after finding these values, now you have to calculate what is the value of K and what is the value of L. So what is the value of K? K means 1 by 6 K1. Next we calculate K and L. 1 by 6 multiplied by K1 plus 2 times K2, 2 times K3, 2 times K4. So 1 time K4. Now already we have these K1, K2, K3, K4. This K value comes to be minus 0.015 0125. This is the value of K, and L value is equal to minus 0.3004993 times. Okay. But the formula is 1 by 6 should be L1, 2 times L2, 2 times L3 plus of L4. After finding these values, now you have to calculate what is Y1 and what is Z1. That is Y1 equal to Y at X equal to X1. That is at point 1. What is the equation we have defined? Y0 plus K. That is Y0 is 3 and K value is minus 0.015. This is the value. Then Y1 takes the value. It is 2.9849875. Then next is Z1. This is also same type. Z at X equal to X1. Then Z at X equal to X1. That is at 0.1. This is equal to Z0 plus L. This is equal to Z0 is 0 minus L value is minus 0.300499. Then finally, this is the value same 0.300499. These are the values of Y1 and X1. So to calculate the value of Y at X equal to X1, we have to consider the equation, that is Y0 plus K, where K will be in terms of 1 by 6 K1 plus K, 2 times K2 plus 2 times K3 plus K4. That is the equation. And Z1, that is Z0 plus L, and L values we have calculated. L1, L2, L3, L4, but L value we have calculated, this is the numerical value, minus of 0.300499, this is the value of L. Then we will add that value to Z0, so as to get, this is the value of Z0. Then as per the table which I have written, I will conclude this calculated values in the table, that is X, Y and Z. What is the first set? It is X0, Y0, Z0. They are the given values. They are the given values means X0 equal to 0 in the initial condition and Y0 is equal to 3 and Z0 is equal to 0. Then X1. This X1 should be X0 plus H, that is equal to 0 plus 0.1. And Y1, Y0 plus K, that is equal to 2.984978, that is 75. Then Z1, this is Z0 plus L, this is equal to 0 point, that is with minus sign, 0.3004, it is 999. So these are the values. This is the first step or first approximation we can call. That means at X1, Y1 and Z1 we have calculated. Similarly, you can go for the calculation for the next value of H, that is X0, X0 plus H equal to X1, X0 plus 2H is equal to X1 plus H is equal to X2. Then X0 plus 3H is equal to X2 plus H, this is equal to X3. This gives Y1, this gives Y2, this gives Y3, etc. Like this, at different steps, so different values of X we can substitute successively, X0, Y0, X0, X1, X2, X3, and the corresponding values of dependent variable. That means Ringer-Putta method gives the set of tabulated values, not in the form of an expression, that is in terms of x and y. In the similar fashion, let me take another example to calculate the value of y and z at the first value of x using the same Runge-Kutta method. The problem is like this.
Apply fourth order method to approximate y at x equal to 0.2, y at x equal to 0.2 with the initial conditions. Y0 equal to 1, y dash 0 equal to 2, and clearly it is given x is equal to 0.2. For the differential equation, that is second order, d square y divided by dx square equal to x into dy by dx and plus of y square. There is no change in the procedure what we utilized to solve the previous problem. In the same time, we will carry out the steps and then we can write the solution. What is the value of y at x equal to x1 and what is the value of z at x equal to x1 as z1. So we will reconstruct the given equation. This is second order differential equation. Once again I will write the same type of steps. Let this can be taken as, that is d square y divided by dx square is equal to x into dy by dx and plus of y square as y double dash equal to x into z plus of y square, that is z is equal to dy by dx, this can be written as, this can be dz by dx is equal to x into z plus y square. Then what are the two equations? Define dy by dx is equal to z, that is equal to f1 of x comma y comma z, and that is dz by dx is equal to f2 of x comma y comma z, and this is equal to x into z and plus of y square. So x naught is the value 0 and y naught is 1 and z naught is equal to 2 and y at x equal to 0.2 equal to how much, and z at x equal to 0.2 equal to how much, because x1 is equal to x0 plus h. What is the value of x0? It is 0 given plus 0.2. This is equal to x1, that is equal to 0.2. This is the value. Now we will define the values of k1, k2, k3, k4 and L1, L2, L3, L4 from the Runge-Kutta method what we studied. So then let me use the equations of K and equations of L, and finally we will consider what is the value of, that is
k value finally and the l value. Okay. Here the procedure you can repeat. The calculated values I will mention. You can in your leisure time you can simply check these answers. From this k1 is equal to 0.0 and l1 is equal to 0.2. So the same equations where l and k we have to define. Then k2, this is equal to 0.02, 0.02, and l2 is equal to 0.202. Next k3, this is equal to 0.0202, and l3 takes the value 0.24402, and k4, that is 0.04804, and l4, that is 0.21, it is 8327. Then we need to define the value of k and value of l. Therefore, k is equal to 1 by 6 multiplied by k1 plus 2 times it is k2 plus 2 times k3 plus k4. Accordingly, 1 by 6 multiplied by k1, that is 0.0 plus of 2 into 0.02 plus of 2 into 0.0202 plus k4, 0.048804. This is the value of k such that the value of k comes to be 0.021534. This is the value of k according to the last equation, and value of l, let us calculate. This is k, and value of l is equal to 1 by 6, that should be l1, 2 times l2, 2 times l3 plus l4. Accordingly, 1 by 6 multiplied by l1 is 0.2, and 2 times this is 0.202 plus of 2 times, that is 0.24402 plus of 0.21, that is 8327. The value of L comes to be 0.21833. Then finally, what we calculate? Y1. This is y at x equal to 0.2 should be y0 plus k. So y0 is the given initial condition, that is 1, and k value is 1 plus of 0.021534 should be obviously, that is 1.021534. This is the value of y1. Then z1, z0 plus l, that is z0 value, that is equal to 2 plus of this value 0.2183, it is 27. That comes to be, that is 2.2183, it is 27. This is the value of z1. Then similarly, if you want to calculate next value, since h is equal to 0.2, if you want to calculate what is the value of y at x equal to 0.4, that is nothing but x0 plus 2h, otherwise x1 plus h, otherwise it is called x2. then similarly z value. Then what all that you have to do is, in the series of equations for L and K, you have to replace that suffix, that means subscript of the symbol x comma y and z, with one unit in advance. That means replace x naught, y naught, z naught by x1, y1, z1, so that you will be getting the next approximation, that is called second value of x. When it is the second value of x, it is at x equal to x2, and the present calculation is at x equal to x1. So one more problem I will write on the same, so that you can check the answer. One more answer I will give, one more problem and answer I will give. Afterwards I shall discuss the next topic. The problem is like this. Solve y double dash equal to x cube into y plus it is dy by dx with it is y 0 equal to 1, y dash 0 equal to 0.5 and h is equal to 0.1. Apply RK fourth order method. Apply RK fourth order method. So when you are writing this fourth order method, when you put a fourth order method here, as usual the same symbols I can make use and give the calculated values. This problem also we have solved. Calculated values I will give, then we can check that answer. Here the second order y double dash equal to x cube into y plus that is dy by dx. This implies y double dash, this implies y double dash means dz by dx, that is equal to x cube into y plus z, one equation. This you call it as f2 of x comma y comma z. Then dy by dx we have introduced, where dy by dx is equal to z. You take this one as f1 of x0, y0, sorry, x comma y comma z. This is f1 and this is f2. Accordingly, solution you have to write for y at x1, that means y at point 1 equal to how much, and z at point 1 equal to how much. Here k1 equal to, that is means y at x1 equal to y0 plus k, z at x1 is equal to z0 plus l. So for k you need 1 by 6, that is k1 plus 2 times k2 plus 2 times k3 plus k4, and this value of k comes to be 0.0202, and similarly this L value comes to be 1 by 6 multiplied by L1 plus L2 by 2 times plus 2 times L3 plus L4. This value comes to be, this is for L, 0.20404, where k1 0.0, k2 0.02, k3 0.0202, k4 0.040804. Then L1 will be 0.2, L2 equal to 0.202, L3 that is 0.20402, and L4 0.20122. These are the details. You have solved this problem and you can verify all the calculated values. So like this, several problems you can try in the similar fashion, wherein the topic is has limitation, otherwise restriction, second order ordinary differential equation by Runge-Kutta method should be the given data, then the initial conditions is compulsory, afterwards the set of formulas you'll have to use properly, and then see that what is the value of k and what is the value of l you have to obtain. That is here this is not k1, k, then k value, then l1, k1, k2, k3, k4, and l value is it takes l1 and l3, l4. So these are the calculations. So with this I would like to stop this discussion. Then in my next lecture I will discuss about application of Milne's method using predictor corrector methods. Once we will predict the value and another time we will make the correction. So predicted value has to be taken as the functional value calculation and then it has to be corrected. So that is predictor corrector methods, and this is directly set of tabulated values. I will continue that Milne's method in my next discussion. Thank you.